everyone, welcome you all to Imagination Gallery. Here we try to show you different types of drawings and stories behind it. So if you are an art lover and wants to know the unknown facts, press the subscribe button now. Now let me introduce you to today's topic. Today in our World 2 series, we will traverse and illustrate the city that never sleeps and called the Big Apple, New York, San Francisco. So watch till the end to experience this stunning journey, paintings and stories on New York. My dear friends, it's been a long time now we are doing this World Tour series. And of course, we have traveled through many different countries, places, their people, culture, their lives. And of course, all these through virtually with the colors and canvas, with the eyes of art. And today's topic, which is already you know, that street mural painting. So I was kind of, you know, obliged to showcase New York because modern street art has well documented origins dating from New York City's graffiti boom. Along with it, the history of street art originated with tagging or scratching names on public property. Graffiti artists in 1970s and 1980s began to inspire people like Keith Haring, who did chalk drawings on the New York City subway system before rising to prominence in the art world. So I really couldn't went ahead with the World Tour series ignoring New York, without New York. So, and of course, who doesn't want to, you know, travel NYC, the city of dreams? Now about street art. Much of street art can now be defined as modern street art has well documented origins dating from New York City's graffiti boom. With its infancy in 1960s, maturation in 1970s and taking high with the spray painted full car, subway, train murals of the 1980s centered in the Bronx. Some of the earliest expressions of street art were certainly the graffiti, which started showing up on the sides of trains and cars and walls. This was the work of gangs in 1920s and 1930s New York. The impact of this subversive culture was extraordinarily felt in the 1970s and 1980s. The cultural movement was recorded in the book The History of American Graffiti, in this book by Roger Gatzman and art in New York City sits squarely at the center of an explosive global urban art movement. The city overflows with murals from local talent as well as international artists. Taggers like Blade use the subway system as a moving canvas, spreading graffiti to all corners of the New York. Today there is still plenty of grit and graffiti all over the NYC. However, there is also a coordinated effort to commission legal murals. Two such efforts include the Bushwick Collective, which runs an annual mural festival in Brooklyn, and the LISA project, which commissions small murals on storefront gutters and in select spots in Little Italy. From the world-renowned Bowery mural in the city's Lower East Side district to Keith Haring's iconic Crack is Racked mural in Harlem, here is a definite list of the best street art locations in New York City. First is Banksy's Hammer Boy mural. In 2013, the ever-elusive Banksy put up his Hammer Boy piece on 79th Street near Broadway at Manhattan's Upper West Side District. Next one is Big Pun Memorial Mural. So this Big Pun Memorial mural, Big Pun Memorial takes the cake for the most iconic mural wall in the Bronx. The notorious Tad Screw created this mural as homage to the late Puerto Rican hip-hop artist. And next is Bowery Mural. Nearly this one is very famous and this is not to be missed. So nearly 40 years ago, Keith Haring placed his artwork on the sprawling Bowery Mural wall in the New York City. Shortly afterwards, many other countless artists vandalized the concrete canvas with their graffiti tags. Os Jimios, Shepherd, Kini Short, Ron English are just a handful of artists who have participated in the public art program on the wall that was organized by renowned curator Jeffrey, teamed up with the late Tony Goldman of the Goldman Global Arts. Next comes the Boschwick Collective. It has developed an outdoor street art gallery in Brooklyn since 2011. Curator of the collective, Joseph Fikelora, has wrangled artists from different parts of the globe to create murals starting on Jefferson Street all the way to Troutman Street towards St. Nicholas Avenue. And apart from all these, there are plenty of street murals in San Francisco and as well as the New York City, because it has originated this art. Just to name many other few of them, like in many others, 128th Street in Manhattan, an LISA project in NYC, Os Jimios mural at 2nd Avenue and 1st Street in East Village, Tough City murals, Wailing Court Mural Project, Graffiti Hall of Fame, Freedom Tunnel, First Street Green Cultural Park, Dumbo Walls, Pony Art Walls, Center Fuge Public Art Project are some of the names to be mentioned. Let's know something about San Francisco and New York. Apart from street murals, what are the things there? There are plenty of things. San Francisco, which is officially known as the city and the county of San Francisco, is a cultural, commercial, financial center in Northern California, and it is named a vibrant hotbed of art and culture among major urban cities in this SMU Data Arts White Paper. And you will see all form of arts here: painting, sculpture, glasswork, drawing, photography, printmaking, everything. And San Francisco is famous for its Golden Gate Bridge, steep streets, Alcott's, and of course, you got it, Full House, the 13th largest city in the United States, also has some pretty interesting historical facts as well, which we might can discuss later in other parts of the series. Now about the New York. New York is often called New York City to distinguish it from the New York State, or NYC for short. This is the most populous city in the United States. New York City has been described as the cultural, financial, and media capital of the world, significantly influencing commerce, entertainment, research, technology, education, politics, tourism, art, fashion, sports. Well, what is not there? And this is the most photographed city in the world, home to headquarters of the United Nations. New York is an important center for international diplomacy and has sometimes been called the capital of the world. And this city has more than 2,000 art and culture organizations and more than 500 art galleries. The city government funds the arts with a larger annual budget than the National Endowment of the Arts. My dear friends, one of the greatest cities in the world, New York is always a whirlwind of activity with famous sights at every turn and never enough time to see all of them. Some people came here to enjoy, to watch the Broadway shows, others come specifically to shop and dine, and many come simply to see the sights, the Statue of Liberty, Empire State Building, Brooklyn Bridge, Central Park, historic neighborhoods and numerous world famous museums. So there is no other city on the planet with an energy that can compete with New York. The fast pace, the buzzing traffic, the hustle bustle of the people, the 24-hour life and the creative spirit make NYC one of the most vibrant places in the world. Well, our World Tour series will continue. We will continue to search this happiness and joy to share only with you, with all of you. Let this be one family. Let's color the life with Imagination Gallery. Enjoyed today's expedition to the city of dreams, the Big Apple, New York City. Transmit your feedbacks and suggestions about our drawing sessions here in the comment box. And if you like our drawing sessions and you want to know about different paintings and the stories behind it, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. Here's wishing you an amazing week ahead. Stay safe and take care. Bye for now.